Dun on.
Dun. What's up? It's been a while, huh? It's been a while. Well, how you doing? We just got back from Ohio and Michigan. We went out there and I got to actually see Lake Erie, which was very cool. So I got that out of the way. So I finally got to see a great lake, and I hadn't never seen a great lake before. So that was awesome. And my friend decided to surprise me. She got this a while back. I think if her mother found out, she'd be quite upset. But this is kind of a tribute freaking video, because the guy who originally did the title of this video, he's a really nice guy. And he seems like one of the Scott Grove freaking fanboys. Not that I have anything against you, Scott. I love you to death. God bless you. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't be doing them either, to be honest with you. Not that I'm anywhere near it, but at all whatsoever. What we have here, ladies and gentlemen, is... let's see if we can get you a nice little headshot. It is an Alvarez Custom Classic. I'm looking at the monitor to make sure you can see it right. Regular style tuners. The serial number is 42222-59. Made in Korea, it says. Serial number, yeah. Is Korea. And this one had the floating bridge, but the floating bridge was not done very well, spring-wise. So I had to move the claw. I moved the claw all the way there, because she was just going out of tune every which way. And it's a really weird looking. Only like the tap horn is a little weird looking, but that's about it. Outside of that, she seems to do okay. The strings are really old. The tuning keys were all looser than shit. The strings were wound backwards, so it comes with string trees. I redid the strings. The strings are still, like I said, the old strings that when she got it back, because she lent it out to somebody, I think a family member or whatever, and they had it for a little while, and they didn't fall in love with the guitar, so she got it back not too long ago with the crate amp, which I thought was freaking hilarious, because the gentleman who was doing the video had a crate amp. Crate amp for the first time, and as well, it's a GX-20M. It's got a clean channel. I haven't taken a look to see if it has foot switchable, but it has a clean channel, has an overdrive channel, it has chorus as well as reverb. I don't have the chorus on, I just have the reverb on. That's the clean channel, and the clean channel is up to about 1 o'clock. 1 o'clock. And the reason why I wanted to put this out there in the vein that I'm putting it out there in is because the guy seems like a very nice guy. He looks like he has vision problems and stuff like that, and he's been playing for a while, and he's got his stuff down, and he's learning it, and he's learning very well, the blues and stuff like that. Like I said, he's a Scott Grove student, just learning a lot of stuff off of, you know, groovy guitar lessons, I guess it's called. So, 1995 rosewood neck, and it's got, I was gonna say it's got a D-shaped neck, but it's a very different style of D-shaped neck. It's like a very spread out C, if I can claim it that. I haven't thrown the Komaseyamas on there to see what the gauge is, but if I was to give it a freaking, I would say it's in and around 12 to 16 radius, because it's very flat. And I just got it together. The pots were shot, so I sprayed some gook in there, threw some WD-40 on the strings, swiped down the strings, didn't do anything with the neck yet. Really just playing with it, haven't done anything with the intonation yet. Messed around a little bit with the saddle heights, just because the action was like it was all the way up there. Did that. The neck was looking all kinds of freaking crazy. It had been in storage for a while. I don't know if it was in a garage or a basement or whatever, but there was some water damage to the freaking guitar case itself. I don't know if you could see, but that was the scarring that was left on the freaking, you know, from the water damage on the leather strappy do. 5-way position switch. And it has a wild ass flat butt body. Now, and these knobs, this is just hysterical. And but otherwise, I threw this pickup on here to, you know, to see what it would be like. She's a little squeaker. She likes the pinchies. But otherwise, not bad. I've been freaking, you know. You know, running it through its paces ever since I started putting it together. The nut is fine. I don't know. It's got to be a plastic nut or whatever. The guy said that he got it for about $160. I'm sure it was used. I can't remember. I didn't look to see when he had purchased it. So, and I'm jumping already. That's because I have had my computer on for a while. So, forgive me if the quality tends to degrade a touch. But outside of that, I mean, she plays fine. There's like, she plays fine. This reminds me of a hip shot. You remember the hip shot, freaking the hip shot, you know, but like not the whammy style, but the more flatter style. So I tightened this up because it was seriously floating and it wouldn't freaking hold I'd bend it in and she would just go every which way. Then I tried freaking tuning it up and tuning it between tuning it, and tuning that, and this being loose as it was, just wasn't, you know, every time I tune up the low E, the high E would freaking go out and shit like that. So I was like, yeah, you're getting on my nerves. Let's get something a little bit more attainable here. Thank you. said, I threw some dirt on there before, and she was squealing like a watch. Been a while. Saying and if she does go out, nice. An Alvarez. It's an Alvarez Custom Classic, or Classic Custom. It was a freebie. And so I was thinking, what can you do with it? It has a swimming pool cavity, so you're pretty much allowed to do anything you want. I'm almost tempted to freaking throw this thing together and put it as a, I want to see, because right now, it's, there ain't nothing wrong with it. Enjoy it for what it is. And turn it into, well, here's what I was thinking, and then you guys can freaking comment if you want, but throwing the whatchamacallit on there for a Telecaster style, getting this, because this is a recessed, Gomasayama, and I'd have to freaking fill that up, put the freaking thing in there for the holes, or have it be over the top mount for the strings, for the string load. But it's got great ring. It's just nice. I mean, if I can get that freaking done right, that would be a huge difference. And then have that filled in right to take the plate for the telly, right? And then fill this in, and then do the routing for the telly guts. And then let's spend about $300-$400 and get the Fishman Fluence, you know, the Greg Koch Fishman Fluence, because it sounds freaking awesome as it is. But it really does have a freaking telly feel to it. I mean, so I don't know, man. And then throwing that in there together, it would wind up being from free to like the one of the most expensive guitars I have. I don't know. What do you think? So, neck pickup. Clean channel. Middle pickup. Right, so I want to beat you up too bad, which normally happens on the middle channel, right? Middle pickup, I mean. That, I got it raised just a little bit, but, and there ain't no thing, that's bright. But that's the, you know what I mean? It's got, you got the pickup on a freaking 250K pot, so it's gonna be like that. So dial it back a touch. So now you got this and this. And now let's go second position. Got a lot of travel in between the two of them, so the tone knobs work really well. I clean them out with the contact cleaner. I use CRC, you know, typical crap, you know, nothing special. So, and just go in there and I spray it up. I just lifted the damn thing up, got in there where the spacing was, where the legs come out of the pots, and just sprayed it in there and just worked them until they, you know, they stopped. Major crackle. So I pulled out, did that until I got most of the crackle out. The pivots, what I did with the pivots was I lowered the pivots a bit in order to improve the action, to lower the action. Because I didn't want to get, I was going to start doing the saddles, lowering the saddles, but they started coming up. You know, the little pins in there, the adjustable pins in there started coming up. And I'm like, there's ways of going around this. So I still need to work on the intonation just to make sure that that's working out fine. But outside of that, seems to be doing okay so far. I'm pretty sure if I start flipping out with, you know, a lot of string bending, she's gonna, you know, she's gonna freak out a little bit, because first of all, there's, I don't know how old the strings are, how long it had been not played for. The neck is still adjusting because I had just, you know, redid it to take up the slack. Like I said, the tuning pegs were, they were like, there was nothing to them. They were like totally loose and shit like that. So I tightened those up and everything. Got this tightened up. And so it's flat up against the body with the blade still right up against the pivot. And the pivot, what I did with the pivots is I just put it just above the plate so that the bottom of the adjusting pin was just above the plate. And so once I had it there, I figured, well, that seems like, you know, a standard industry freaking thing to have that at that location, because it's just high enough to be above the frets, but not too high so that it's insane. So there is some meat on there. There is some space on there. So it, if I wanted to bang on the slide for a little bit, I could bang on the slide for a little bit. And then I'm going over, and I apologize for going over, but I'm saying, so it does a lot of stuff, and that's still on position two. So I don't know, if you find one, try it out and see what, you know, see how it comes for you. I'm sure it's just like anything else, you know, you find a dog and you find a good one, and this one happened to be one of the freaking good ones. So I don't find too much more work that I would need to do with it. I mean, it looks like it's a decent platform to play on and play with and customize and do whatever the hell you want to do. He said he picked it up, I don't know how, I didn't even check the date on it. $160 he was able to pick it up for. Alvarez Classic. Alvarez. A-L-V-A-R-E-Z. Alvarez. So, is this one of those ones that the Alvarez, that the frickin' whatchamacallit, Sustainiac? Oh, no, those are Hernandez, aren't those? I think those are Hernandez. But the Alvarez, they also make frickin' acoustics. I know, because I've seen the guys frickin' come break them out, the old ones, so. It's made in Korea. I think I mentioned that. As far as I understand, it says it on the headstock, so I don't know what else, everything else freaking is, but that's the story with that, and with that, I'm gonna let you guys go. And tell me how, you know, how the things are going. I'm accruing trolls lately, so if I get a little freaking funky, it's because I'm like, come on, man. 7 billion people on the fucking planet, and your ass has to freaking say something stupid? I mean, that hasn't died out yet, you know? Grow the fuck up. Goddamn Poindexter looking motherfuckers. I didn't need a guitar to get laid. With that, I will say goodbye. Hello, thank you very much. Beautiful thing. When you come up, check it out. I think you'll like what I did.
I think you'll like it a lot.
All right, folks, have a good one. Peace. I'll talk to y'all later. Have a good one, and I hope you had a great... You're having a great summer, man. Enjoy this freaking heat, man. It's almost out of here. A couple of more months. We'll see. Peace.